Students, welcome to the class again. This is your teacher Ragini Tiwari. So student, as we have already started the chapter, A Retrieved Reformation, written by O. Henry. Let us continue the story from page number 15. Without wasting time, a student, be ready with your pen or pencil to write the hard word with their meanings. So that's Jim Valentine's work. What's Jim's Valentine work? He was a burglar. He's resumed business. He's got the only clamps that can do, please underline the word clamps, that can do such a clean job. Yes, I guess I want Mr. Valentine. What is the meaning of clamps? Clamps means tools which hold two things together. A tools which hold two things together. So here Mr. James Valentine, after coming out from the jail, through his higher level connections from the criminals, okay, he was out of the jail and now he was about to search his new, you can say, a new burglary case, a new to crack a new safe, okay, as it was his job. But now this time he wants to start a business. This time Mr. Valentine wants to start a business. So yes, it, because burglary was his clean job, he was expert in it, but before doing that he has to resume something else. He has to plan something else to do a best burglary. One afternoon in Elmore City, Jimmy, looking like an athletic young student just home from college, went down the broad footpath towards the Platters Hotel. One afternoon, it was a time of afternoon when he was in the city. He changed his city. Now he was in the city Elmore. He was in Elmore and his look perhaps changed. He looked like so young, dynamic student. Okay, not like a burglar, not like a person who returned from the jail. No, he looked like a very dashing personality, like a young student, college student, and he was walking through the footpath towards the Planters Hotel. Where he was going? Towards the Planters Hotel. A young lady crossed the street, passed him at the corner, and entered a door over which was a sign, the Elmore Bank. Jimmy Valentine looked into her eyes, forgot what he was, and became another man. She lowered her eyes and colored slightly. Young men of Jimmy's style and look were sacred in Elmore City. Sacred means in short, simply. As Jimmy was in Elmore City and he was walking walking towards the hotel, Platmore's Hotel, what interacted with him? Actually, a young lady passed away from that way. Okay, crossed that way, and what the Jimmy observed? Jimmy looked at that lady, and that time he lost in himself. As soon as he saw the lady, he lost him in himself. Okay, and the Elmore Bank, it was the scene of Elmore Bank. Jimmy Valentine looked into her eyes. As soon as he looked into the lady's eyes, forgot what he was. Jimmy forgot that what he actually was. He was a burglar, but he forgot. He thought that he was another man. He was not a burglar, he was something else. The lady shied. The lady, when she lady also looked in his eyes, she blushed. Young men of Jimmy's style and looks were scarce in Elmore City, because Jimmy's style person was in Elmore City was a really outstanding thing, really a good thing for that lady, and as soon as she also observed, she blushed. Jimmy collared a boy that was loafing on the steps, of the bank, and began to ask him questions about the town, feeding him coins and at intervals. By and by the young lady came out and went her way. Jimmy captured a boy who was loafing on the steps. Loafing means Loafing means spending time aimlessly, doing nothing. A boy who was doing nothing, Jimmy caught that boy and one by stepwise step, he was giving him some coins and asking some questions. The boy was answering, asking question about the town, what was in the town and how was the town. Many questions he was asking and the boy was answering, and in intervals Jimmy was feeding him coins, giving him coins, giving him money. Again the young lady came out from that bank, Almore Bank. She came out and went her way. She moved to her way. Isn't that young lady Polly Simpson? Asked Jimmy. Jimmy pretend here. Actually he was not knowing the lady, but he pretended. He pretended to the boy that that lady name was Polly Simpson. No, said the boy. The boy replied, no, no, she was not Polly Simpson. She is Annabel Adams. What's the name of lady? Annabel Adams. The boy, that this is how Jimmy came to know what is the real name of the lady, Annabel Adams. Her pa owns this bank. Means this bank belongs to Annabel Adams' father. Her pa's own this bank. This bank belongs to Annabel's father. More coins filled the boy's pocket as Jimmy extracted information about Annabel Adams. Jimmy, again, he wants some more information about Annabel Adams. That's why he gave the boy some more coins. Okay, students, listen this video again and again. We will continue this story in our next video. Take care. Have a nice day.